Yom Kippur was two history points. Not only the forgiving Yom Kippur was also two points. One is the beginning of the Jewish history. The second boat was giving Yom Kippur. After 120 days, Yom Kippur was forgiving. The Moshiach gives the second boat. It's like, we can say that the finish of the Matan Torah was in Yom Kippur. Started Shavuos, we lost us in Shavuos of Tammuz, and he broke the first boat, and we get it again in Yom Kippur. So it's the Matan Torah, like Shavuos, was finished in Yom Kippur. Why I say this? I want to explain something interesting in this point. Yom Kippur War started in Shabbos Yom Kippur was. The same day Yom Kippur. So I mean that every year when you come Yom Kippur and you say Shechiyonu, Shechiyonu Kimon Mazman Azeh, we must have attention also of this miracle. But we don't have the attention of this because we are very busy with the Tshuva. We pray for the life and we pray for everything. We are very busy, so we don't have attention to think about these two points. Matan Torah was the finish of the Matan Torah was in Yom Kippur. Why I say this? If you want to make contact with Shavuos, it was also a big miracle in Shavuos. 13 years ago, you heard about the atom reactor that was in Baghdad. Saddam Hussein built the atom reactor against the Jew.
Yeah.
You know the name? 17 in Tammuz. You understand what it means?
Yeah, 17 in Tammuz.
What is 17 in Tammuz?
It's a special day for us.
What was called this Jerusalem?
The temple, yeah.
The temple is Tishat, the city.
No, 17 in Tammuz is when they first broke into the temple. The day they breached the
walls. The walls of the city.
Breached the walls.
Breached the walls of the city. When we destroyed the atom reactor, you know, Shavuos. So it's, if you understand.
Like a circle, yeah.
A circle. We lost Shavuos in Shavuos of Tammuz, and it was broken in the worlds. He wanted to make for us a new Shavuos of Tammuz, and the Rebbeinu Shalom gave us the Siyata Dishmaya to destroy it when? Which Shavuos, you know? The second day of Shavuos. By second day Shavuos, because it's Orator. The Rabbanon, to teach us how much important. Also, I want to say something about Sukkot. I have a big question. Why Sukkot is in winter, not in when we went out, but in the spring? Why is autumn? You know the question. Rabban asked this, who asked this? They ask, why we made the festival of the 10th Sukkot. They started in Pesach and went out from Egypt. What says the Vilnagoyen? The Vilnagoyen says something interesting. He says something nice. Because the Vedra say after the scene of the Gold Cup scene, stop with the Ananaka of the cloth of other cloth stopped when she came and returned back after Yom Kippur. So Sukkot is at the same time is a good time to festival the other Kippur, the neck of it. Because they come back after Yom Kippur. I believe this cloth was again in the sixth world, in the Yom Kippur world. Why? The vendors explain what already the Chumash, that the cloth, it was over the camp, the Jewish camp, he came and split between the Jew and the Egypt. Say the Medrash, why? Because the shoot of the camp of the Jew, he catched it. It doesn't matter, Rashi. Rashi say, why was the cloth between the Jew and the to hold up the stones and the narrow but shoot on the Jew. I believe that this cloth was in Yom Kippur War, but it hid we don't see in flesh eyes, but I assure that it was. I want to explain, because I want to make contact between what was the miracles, what will help us to destroy the atom reactor in Baghdad, and also what saved us from Egypt. Why I want to talk about this? Because the weather says so, and the Tilin Kufay will say, Sichu Bechol Niflotam. You must tell his miracles. You must tell the miracles. If nobody else tells the miracle from the Yom Kippur War, we will talk about it. What can I do? I feel not so best in this, because I feel that we missed something. This was the General Lutz from NATO, the head of NATO. He say only miracles stop the tanks of Egypt and Syria. Not was anything to drop there, because it was very, the Jews were very surprised. They wasn't prepared for the war. He says it was very difficult. Also, if you heard the name of the son of Rav Herzog, the chief rabbi was Rav Herzog, his son, was, we explained everything in the military explanation what we need. He told it was one of the biggest miracles of the Jewish nation.
You know, the generals, they told Golda Meir 2 days before what's going on. She didn't believe it.
They don't believe it. Yes, I know. Why? I will say the Medrash. He Simcha won't know the Medrash, but I will tell you what are the Medrash. I read the Medrash. What happened? The branch should have closed the eyes of the Jewish government here. I will explain why. Reshit Rabbah, in the Medrash Reshit Rabbah says so, Akol v'cheska tzumim, everybody is like blind. Ad shakadosh baruch hu pokech et enem, till the Lord will open the eyes. We pray also every day, v'techezena eneinu b'shulcha l'tzion. What is the prayer? What's the meaning of the prayer? You know what the meaning of the prayer? Open the eyes to see how you return to the Lord. Not only we want to be in this time when you will come back. No, every minute you come back. But we don't know this, we don't recognize it. Because this we must pray about it. The Rebbeinu shall open our eyes. We want to see what will happen here. Because this, I want to talk about this Yom Kippur War, because we are obligated to talk about it. Srichu b'chol kloisot. And I don't see that other people say it. We will try to talk about it and what we can. I read the Medrash. Mitzvat ase, commanded, l'itbonen v'chazda Hashem, in the kindness of the Rebbeinu Shalom, you must check it and learn it. שנאמר וזכרת את כל הדרך אשר הוליך השם אלוקיך את הדברים שלו. You must remember your whole life, your whole history. What? The kindness of the Rebbeinu Shalom made us when we went to the desert. הכיל חתמן, הפית על סימן, שמלתך לא בלטה, ויזוגי גרמנט. ומנין ללמוד מכאן לא חומר. From this we must learn. If we need to remember what was more than 3,000 years ago, or we'll be obligated to talk about what happened now in our ages. אם נצטבר לזכור החסדים שעשה עם אבותינו, כל שכן שכל אחד מישראל חייב לזכור החסדים שעושה עמנו תמיד לכלל ישראל. For private miracles and also the nation, for the nation, the miracles for the nation. Yom Kippur War is for the nation, because now the Israel is the center of the Jewish nation. If Chalile, he has a problem. The center is all the nation is a problem. שמציל אותנו, he save us every time, משיני הריות from the teeth of the lions, רשעים עומדים עלינו, what means lions? רשעים עומדים עלינו לחלתנו. Also, I say, אריה שאג, מי לא יראה? You know the words, אריה שאג, the lion, ונשאר. הוא לא פריד. אריה is אלול, ראש השונה, יום כיפר ראשון הרבה. I want to explain not more than what it means. If you know, the Holocaust started אלול. 39. When it was finished? 46. It was Hashanah
Rabbah. 45, I thought.
I know what you will say, but when Rabbi said it was finished in Hashanah Rabbah 46, there was hanging the 10 leaders of the Nazis. This was Hashanah Rabbah.
Purim.
Hashanah Rabbah. This was like Purim, because they say that it's a Jewish Purim, the new Jewish Purim.
Perfect, yeah.
But this was Hashanah Rabbah, Aryeh, is Elul Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur Hashanah Rabbah. Also the Yom Kippur war was very bad in the beginning, if you know. Very bad. Dayan, the minister of Pentagon in the United States.
Defense minister.
He come, tell the guy, the prime minister, they're all finished. Our heels, I don't know if it's right, they want to be suicide.
No, they said the third temple was finished.
Yes, but
they
want to suicide themselves because they was afraid to fall.
They said the third temple was finished, and they loaded the planes with the nuclear bombs. They had them loaded.
It's two searches about it. Not so sad.
No, that's not one of the guys who put the missile. One of the guys who put the bomb on the plane. He said they put the bomb on the plane. It's in everywhere. Just Google it. The guy who actually put the bomb on the plane.
Today I looked in the Google. It's not so simple.
Yeah. The guy who put the bomb on the plane, he actually wrote a book about it. The guy who put the bomb on the plane. They said they had the bomb, they had the plane launched already. And then
they
ran on the third division.
No, I want to talk why you need to learn this story. First of all,
you know what? They should have dropped it on the third division. It would have been less
problems. The first point, are written in the Bible, Sikho Bechol Niflasav. You must talk about the miracles. That is to talk about the miracles. And he said, if you must remember what happened in the desert 3,000 years ago, of sure you must remember and to talk about it what happened by you in this period, in your life. You are before this, maybe you are 38 years today, this is older than you. But maybe you know this. Yeah, no, you were a child then.
Yeah, 11 years old. But I remember.
לזה אנו אומרים בכל יום, because this we grateful every day, מזמור לולי השם שואל לנו. If the Lord not watch us, the Jewish nation not exist. וכן חייב, this is the nation, חייב כל אחד מישראל, לחזקור החסדים שגמלו השם דורך בעת שיצרו בבית הנימו. Also, he must, the private miracles, ואז יקנה לפניו וימוש וישוב בתשובה שלמה. Say, you must remember what was in the past very long time ago. If so, you must mention what happened for the nation in your period. And also the private nation. The private nation we talk now, we will talk about what happened for the nation. First of all, the Egyptian started in Yom Kippur. Why? They was sure the Yom Kippur did not prepare everybody in the synagogue. This was one of the biggest miracles, you know? This was the biggest miracle. The start Yom Kippur, why?
Because then they came in, and then they saw there were no Jews. And the general said, it must be an ambush because it's a bunch of Jews around. And so he turned around.
But
that happened. Yes, it's my rabbi's book.
No, it's your rabbi's book, but I don't know it. I don't believe that you're right. Listen what was the biggest miracle. So in a regular day, the road is full with cars. You don't can bring weapon, don't can bring. So the whole road was open, so the military have time to travel, and the road was open to bring the, or you say the miluim, the reserves. This second point, everybody was in the synagogue, or at least was next to his house, not in the workplace.
Yeah, nobody was ready.
No, but this was one of the bigger miracles. The first miracle was, this was a miracle. Even the Ben Ishchai talk about it, that will be, Ben Ishchai read some, he wrote something like this, what will be, or Yom Kippur, he say, and upstairs the angels, you know, when we talk about this, upstairs the angels fight with the Jewish nation. He says it will be also in here, in the
Yom Kippur.
He saw something like what happened. I don't know if that's exactly what happened, but very close to what was. This is the first Ness what was Yom Kippur. This was that means the worst day.
It
was the best day. Also because we have the eyes from the Jew was in the synagogue, they was praying. This was the first miracle, Yom Kippur. Second miracle started in the Second World War, you know? You heard about the island Azorim? Azorim.
The Azores?
You know what is it?
It's a port in old Portugal, is it, or something?
Yes, you're right. This was also, Rabbi Yochanan prepared the help in the Second World War. In the Second World War, United States need a good airport to attack Europe.
Mm-hmm.
Where they made it? In the island of Azov. They made a very big airport. And when they started the war, the Jew missed the weapon. They wasn't prepared for the war. So we need help. Who will come to help? United States will help. No, they don't want to help. What started? Russians bring full weapon to the Arabs. They don't want the Arabs win. The Muslims help the Jews also. But Europe not let the airplane.
Yeah, they won't let them through. Yeah.
They don't let the airplane to the Muslims have a station in the Galaxy airplane don't come.
Yeah, no, I know the story already. Yeah, nobody would allow any weapons to go to Israel. And
yes,
they did it through Portugal.
What better way? Portugal was very good. She needs help from the United States. Yeah. United States, you give me an airport? Yeah, but in Portugal, they don't let. Take the Azorim. Azorim was prepared specially for the airport, for the Galaxy.
Mm-hmm.
This, Rabbi Yochanan prepared this in the Second World War. This airport was prepared for us to help us to bring the Galaxy airplanes. Thirdness, what was very importantness, something very strange they made. You know that what happened? What was the end of the war? When did you win?
When they circled the Third Army.
They went in between the two armies.
Yeah, Sharon was very smart.
He's not so. He
was smart. He was a good general.
He knows that there.
He wasn't scared.
He knows that it's like you say, almost between suicide and victory.
Yeah, have no choice.
Or suicide and victory. This.
Yeah, but he had guts. Nobody else had guts. No. He said to go behind the lines and cut them off.
Nobody, but I mean that nobody from the other general was, not two generals was.
He had guts,
he had the balls. No, only other generals was the way to say it. It's stupid.
It's crazy, but he said we have no choice.
It was crazy. He made also, before he went, he asked the military sing the song, Israel Betav Hashem. He also he understood that it's not help for them and not don't go.
You're also forgetting one thing also, you know. I'm forgetting one part of the story. Golda Meir, one time when Kissinger came, along with the President of the United States, they came to Golda's house, and she came out herself and served them honey cakes. You don't know about this part of the story. She served them honey cakes herself. There was no servants or anything. She sat them down just for tea, Nixon and Kissinger, and gave them honey cakes herself, and gave them tea, and they said to her, well, where's the servants and everything? She said, no, just me. You know, she was just like a Yiddish mama, you know? She just came and gave them honey cakes and everything. Yeah. And like you said, they attacked, and they were losing the war. I still have her speech when she was talking to them on the phone. She said, she called up Henry Kissinger. And you know Kissinger. He says, let the Jews die. He doesn't really care, but he's a Jew, right?
That's not very good.
You don't remember the speech. She told him, she said, if you don't help us, we're finished.
I don't know the story.
It's the truth. The next
could
day,
be, but
the next day, she told him, tell your president about the honey case. Tell us, we're finished. So he sent the next day the tank.
Not the next day, but a few days. Till the Russians send the Arab help.
No. Once they crossed, they were halfway through. And she pleaded with Nixon. She said, please send me. I can show you the whole, it's all on the internet. She pleaded and she got the tanks.
It's not American. I want to talk about American.
Yeah.
When Sharon went in, there was nothing.
He circled around and cut him up behind.
No, when he started to go, Egypt army was laughing.
Of course.
They shoot bombs, but the bombs not tell.
Yeah.
Also, what happened? The officer that was there was killed. Mm-hmm. Come the bigger officer, is also killed. The third officer was over, was killed. So the Egypt militaries don't know what to do.
Yeah, not smart enough.
This was one of the other, I don't know what the level, but three officers that was running of the place, Egypt army, there was killed.
Rabbi, of course you can see God's hand, but you know something. Hashem always says, give me a keli and I fill it for you.
Yes, but
Sharon still had to do his work. Forgot to make the miracle. Do you understand?
I talk about the miracles, not what the...
I know, you don't care about the human, but
to talk about the Nisi, because the Torah say as, Sichu Bechol Niflotav. These 3 points, I don't know if people remember it. The airport in Azorim, the Yom Kippur, exactly this day was prepare for us, because this day was the road open, you can bring the military and the weapon. Third point, when Sharon went in, was killed the old officer that was commandant of this area, these 3 points. Now, I want to talk, what happened after this? After they started the Tshuva movement in Israel. The sixth day started the movement in the United States and Russia. This is a long time before you. After the sixth day, there was much miracle, but for us, it was drunk, or you say victory drunk, or you say it in English.
Victory what?
Drunk. People was this. Victory make him crazy.
Okay.
In Hebrew we say this victory to dog. In English what you say then?
It's a party.
Yeah, there's no word for it.
What word for this?
Victory. No.
So, one of the authors of the newspaper, his name is Amnon Dankner. If 30 years ago he wrote an article about the Tshuva. He went to Yeshiva Osamea, famous Yeshiva Osamea. He went there and he said the majority of his friends was in Yeshiva. He was very surprised. So much friends in one place I never saw like I saw in the Samaria. And he means the Yom Kippur War, he made it. He wrote the revolution or the earthquake, what you say about political earthquake or other earthquake. You forgot that really earthquake is the Tshuva movement. This was checked the nation. You're right. Then started to be I want to tell you a story. I don't know if you know the army. When you talk to the soldiers to say Amen, Avor, Echad, Avor, the number of the time. Tvilat Esh Shona b'Chazit HaTala, when started the war. The first, I don't know if you're in English to say Tvilat Esh, to wash yourself in fire. I don't believe that you have in English the same translation. You have something as a...
Say that again?
Tvilat Esh. Like you go in mikveh, inside.
Yeah, immerse yourself in fire. It's, we have the same term, yeah.
Oh, yes.
No, isn't it like purification by fire or something?
No, it's immerse yourself in
fire.
What do you say?
Immerse yourself in fire.
What is it also say?
It's like taking a dunk in the mikveh in fire.
Immerse yourself.
Immerse.
I've never heard of that. Immerse
yourself? Immerse yourself in the fire. Abraham did that.
Tilat esh rishona. V'chazit otala.
Abraham did that.
Trial by fire, maybe.
No, immerse.
So when
you don't know what the word is for going in the making of the fire. It's immerse yourself.
Do you know my thing? Do we have an expression?
That's I've heard that. Immerse yourself.
I say fire. So. You not esh shona b'chazit
atala. I heard it in quite a few books.
Metasim, Air Force, Artillery, Cannon, Missiles, Krav Nimanimrats, very raw bottle, stone bottle. Very full blood shoot down. After this come the commandant, go in the Gebra Gizrah Merkazi to help, but they go over the Suez Canal. In the place where he was waiting for the, before we go to the war, second of all, he says so. I'm not religious, but I'll be a Jew. I ask everybody who will be to cover his head with a head. Then I start to say, we have a prayer before we go to the war. We cut it apart. And I read the Birkat HaYetzeh LaKlal, then I wrote Azir. I tell the Chavaya Gdola, Nishmo et kol ha-tanki, the whole tanks under me. אחרי שסיימתי קריאת התפילה, כאן אחד, here is one, אמן, עבור. כאן, two, עבור. In the army languages, when you get a phone call, you say, I get it, עבור. Finish, go forward. עבור.
I will come?
So I say, every time, אחד, עבור. שניים, אמן, שלוש, אמן, עבור. So the old tanks, everybody say, אמן. He says it was very, feel very, how you say, the emotion was very, very strong. He said, I'm not religious, but I'll be a Jew. So we must pray before the war. He says that also the old Tassim pilot who or travel the airplane, or your
pilot.
Pilot.
Until
for Air Force, also pilot.
Yeah, until Sharon went behind and knocked out the SAM-7 missile launchers, they were shooting down Israeli pilots like crazy. Two out of every three got shot down.
Yes.
He knocked out the, until Sharon went behind the lines and destroyed all the SAM-7 missile launchers. Before that, they were shooting down all the Israeli pilots.
Not all the Israeli pilots.
Two out of three were going down.
There was 100 airplane.
Yeah, because
the Jew is very summer. Because
of the SAM missiles.
It's something amazing. 100 airplane, Jewish airplane. This is our power was. More 102 airplane.
Yeah.
The shoot down. It's a
SAM missile.
It's a missiles.
Yeah, and Sharon went behind the lines and destroyed them all.
Not only Sharon, Sharon is a main part in this, central part, but we must see the whole miracle all together.
Well, of course the miracle also is God, but God has to use somebody.
I want to say the danger was so much in the first night of the war, Mosse Yom Kippur, they asked to fulfill every container with water, because it was sure that Syria would come to the Jordan, canal, and we will close the water to the
water.
They asked to fulfill every container. They were afraid, and they want to take the old people from the tip from Golan, the old family. But they want to take them from Tveria also. Because they were sure that they will go in Tveria also. It was very close to Tveria. They want to take out the old citizens of Tveria also. Baruch Hashem, we after the soul when we say Shachyonu in Yom Kippur, at least now in Sukkot, because the change became in Sukkot. But I told you, the cloth of the Lord, what was in Egypt, he came again, but we don't saw it our regular eyes. But in the...
And Sukkot is a good time for us.
Sukkot, Torres,
it's a very strong time for the Jews.
This is what I want to tell you, this was so, so this is what is really important to know. Yom Kippur, well, each made a big change. Shesh HaSayomim also is made Russian in the United States, but not here. Here there was, I told you, victory drug in Hebrew, Shikor Nitzachon, Shiker Nitzachon. In Hebrew this is it. This is us. So now we understand why I say Yom Kippur is the second Matan Torah, and the first Matan Torah Shavuos we destroyed the atom reactor. The second, we were saved by the Lord from the war. So now comes Sukkot. You must remember the old miracles and be grateful to the Lord. Amen. This is what I said.
You have to remember those things.
אתה מבין שמחה מה שאנחנו, למה קראתי לכם? I want that you remember it, because people forgot it, I don't like
it.
I don't know why, I don't understand why we forgot it. There's something very kind of we forgot it. Because we are busy very much in Kippur, so we forgot it. Yeah, because Kippur is the time of blessed praying on Tshuva. But the mitzvah is to remember, not forgot this mitzvah.